Complicated games and good rulebooks. I guess those two things should go together, no? But not everyone thinks like that. Let's talk about it. Hi players, bonjour from Paris. My name is Asaf Hirsch and welcome to my channel Easy Board Games. Today I want to talk to you about some complicated games and why it's so rare to find a good rulebook these days. So over the past week or so, I was trying really super hard find out how can I play Europa Universalis Price of Power. Now, this game, guys, is a heavy game, okay? This is definitely probably the heaviest thing that I tried to learn, but without success. And that made me think of some other games that I tried to play recently or a little bit a while ago, and how come every time there is a point that you just hit a wall with those rulebooks. So I decided to do a video about it and hear what do you think about it. Let's start with a game that I think that in its base is really not so complicated, but the rulebook just make it, for me, really almost impossible. It means that it took me really a long time to learn it. And that is Pax Renaissance, the second edition. Now, Pax Renaissance was the first Pax board game that I ever tried. And when I first opened the box, I was really excited because it looked, first of all, very elegant. So all the chess pieces and for me with the beautiful cards, I was really, really excited about it. This mechanism that you like have the market, so you need to put the coins over the cards that you skip. I don't know, for me, it felt really excellent. And from what it appeared, also the game has a lot of depth. So I was very happy to see this kind of a game on a small scale. It means that it doesn't take a lot of space, and it came after a chain of board games that just like took all the tables. The one that I played before it was Perseverance by Mindclash, and it was just like huge on the table. So I was really happy to see a game that has a lot of depth, that is strategic, and doesn't take a lot of space. So try to learn the game, how it goes. So I'm opening the rulebook, I'm like, okay, this is this. And then the terms that just started to go inside, and this is an agent, and this is a non-agent, and you need to do like this and like that. And I'm like, wait. Like I found myself reading the same paragraph maybe 5 times in a row without understanding what the fluff is going on. So I will say it in advance, I'm not the smartest guy in the universe, but I think that by looking over whatever there is behind me, you can see that most of the games that I like are more of the crunchy type. I like to think about games. For me, a complicated game is not something bad. For me, it's something great. Just means that you need to think a little bit more while you're playing. But the frustration that I found myself reading and trying to understand what's going on in Pax Renaissance, the second edition, was just like impossible. So I'm like, all right, maybe really it's just me. Let's see what's going on Board Game Geek. So I'm opening BGG and I'm like, okay, I'm not the only one. So this is probably one of the main criticisms that I saw about this game, is just like how difficult it is to understand this kind of game from the rulebook. So, okay, where do you turn when you don't know how to play? YouTube, right? Someone must have done a how to play, like a playthrough about this game. So I only found, I think, one normal video, and then it took me probably watching that video maybe 5 or 6 times in front of the game, and then reading again like the rule book. And I think it took me really a few good days of understanding, like, oh, okay, so this is how you need to play this game. So for me, Pax Renaissance the second edition is an example of a game that is not so complicated, okay? And the rulebook is just like destroying the experience. Because when you're doing a small jump to a Pax Pamir second edition, you're like, oh, okay. Like, so this is a Pax game, which is amazing, by the way. And it's not complicated. Like, I understand how I need to play it. This is awesome. And then when I tried another Pax game, which is Transhumanity, I'm like, oh my God, now we're going backwards. Or I don't know what came before what. For me, that was the order. It was Renaissance, Pamir, and Transhumanity. And I'm like, I don't understand why are you doing this to me? Why are you doing this? Why do you make the rules so complicated? So jumping to another game, which is what I'm trying to learn right now, this is the fourth edition of Successors. So when I first saw this game, even before I bought it, I'm like, wow, this game looks awesome. So strategy with really the theme that I love, some cool miniatures. Let's see what's going on. I'm buying this game, I'm getting it on the table, and I'm like, oh my God. So in the rule books, they're saying like, yeah, don't be afraid of this rule book. What you should do is have like the playbook, which is basically a whole game just being described. And they're telling you follow that. And then if you have some questions, you can like, you know, consult the rule book itself. So this is already a little bit better. At least this is where they understood that the game is like has a certain degree of complexity. And they're like, we're going to give you a whole book just of like a full playthrough, play by play. This is what we're deciding to do. And to be honest with you guys, this is something that is great. This is what I expect to find in a complicated game that understands, has a self-awareness of this level of complexity. And like, all right, we got you, okay? Forget about the rule book. I mean, when you don't understand something, come and consult this thing. But just for get you started with your first game, don't be panicked by how this rule book looks like. Just go to the to this playthrough that we managed to create another book for you guys and roll with that. For me, it's awesome. But I still have to have a little bit of criticism over here because for me, the rule book is not just like rule number one, rule number two, rule number three. No, it's like, hey guys, I'm a new player to this game, so welcome me into your world, you know? Another type of board game that I can consider here is what I started this video with, and that is Europa Universalis. Now again, this is probably the heaviest game that I ever laid my hands on. Obviously, after 1 week of trying and setting up and redoing and watching videos, and when I say watching videos, I'm saying like 10 and a half hours of playthrough. That is, I think that after 10 hours of watching someone play, you should know how to play, no? So I guess it was not that simple. And every time, doesn't matter if I saw like a playthrough or explanation about the rules and I'm going back to the game and retrying and readjusting and just like playing solo, but like three or four hands actually, because it was France and Castile and then England and the Holy Roman Empire, and I'm like, I don't understand. And then when I'm like reading through the, and I also posted one of my own, but when I'm reading like the threads that you have there in the forums, are like people are saying, don't expect to learn this game by reading the rule book. And I'm like, okay, I get that to some degree. Like, obviously I will not like understand every small detail that there is out there, but to like understand zero of what's going on in the game from the rule book, I'm like, why did you give me a rule book? And if you already have a super complicated game, and I'm not only talking about Europa Universalis, I'm just saying it in general, that if you have such a complicated game, then issue like a video about this, but not just like someone with a camera with its phone that is going from here to, no, that just like, I'm sorry, but you need to pay a little bit more money to someone to make a better video, or find a small channel that is willing to do it for free and just be done with it. No need to pay more money for it. So for me, it was a little bit frustrating, and people are like saying like, yeah, it's better if you're going to let someone teach you this game. Or even in Successors, I have it right over here. And they're saying like, don't be afraid of the rule book, but a better way to learn the game is to have someone teach you. And I'm like, oh wow, guys, you are fucking geniuses. This is amazing. How did I not think about it before? What is it? Pass it forward? What, Kevin Spacey is going to jump from somewhere? Like the designer is teaching three other players, and those three players are teaching three other players. And then like at some point, the whole board game community will understand how to play this game. It's like, no, you just need to do a better rule book. I'm sorry, but I would happily pay 20 more euros, dollars, even 50 more, okay? Because if I have a game, the deluxe version with the extra set of this and extra set of that, And finally, you have like about 250 euros, 300 euros game that you're like, I have no idea what to do with it. So now it's basically just a paperweight. To tell me not to expect to learn the game from the rulebook is basically saying, this is a rulebook in gibberish, or just this is a book with empty pages and you decide to write there whatever you want. No, I'm sorry, you have to make an effort and do a better job. And there are like games that you can see like that. Now, I don't expect every game to be as simple as Everdell, okay? This is, obviously you have complex game. Europa Universalis is a complex game with many moving parts and many things that you can do in this game. But if you do have a complex game, then I expect of you to help me understand it. Now I want to talk about a heavy game that the company that did that understood that this game is going to be heavy, and they said, don't worry, we got you. And that is Voidfall. And this is, by the way, I think the fourth, if not more, video that I'm talking about this game, because every time I find another layer that I like in this game. Now people, and you can see it in the forums of Voidfall, are actually really scared and anxious when they're opening the box and they see like four manuals, let's say, before they understand what each manual is actually all about. So in Voidfall, which is, I think that, I'm pretty sure, okay, that is less heavier than Europa Universalis, nothing to do, but it's definitely on the heavier side, okay? You cannot say that Voidfall is like a medium like a complex game. No, it's on the heavier side. So here, first of all, you have these four manuals before you understand what's going on, but they say, start here. I'm like, you guys, I love you, really. So like they're saying, this is going to be difficult to understand in the beginning, but let's go through the tutorial. We prepared for you, okay? A tutorial scenario that will help you throughout all of your games. And then they're telling you, for the tutorial, you're going to read only what is in this color. And when you see this sign, don't read it. Just like skip, you don't need it for now. Read pages, this to this. Come back, play the first cycle. Go back and read like more things and then come back and complete like the game. And I'm like, this is amazing. I learned this game just from the rulebook. Now, of course, you have Paul's video from Gaming Rules about how to play. Personally, and I'm not taking, you know, anything from the amazing job that he did in his video, I don't think that Voidfall is a game that you can learn from 1 hour of watching this video. I think it's a bit more helpful to go and watch the 4.5 hours that he has, the three-hand playthrough. But I also understand, or I think that it's a little bit hard to sit and watch 4.5 hours of a playthrough. It's not so easy. But the rulebooks of this game are amazing, okay? And then you understand that actually you have the glossary, which is a full manual of just explanation of all the cards. Hey, you don't understand this iconography? Don't worry, we got you covered. We got you covered. Just go to that page and read whatever you want to read about it, and you understand. Most of the questions, and I did a teach of this game like with the group of players, and I did it not in my native language, and they understood, and most of the time when they asked a question was not about the rules, was actually about the iconography. So I think that Voidfall is an amazing example of how a game can be heavy, but the company who's making it is like, guys, I think that we need to make sure that players understand how to play this game. And they really made sure that players will understand how to play this game. So to conclude everything that I'm saying in this video, I think that when a company is telling you, don't expect to learn this game from their just like the rule book, I'm like, then you did hear something that is not good, okay? Because for me, I find it crazy that as a consumer, if I actually bought a game and I need to run all over the place just to find another mean to help me play this game, I think that it's a little bit crazy and something here does not work. I think that companies maybe lean too much today on YouTube, like video that someone will do for this game. And there is no problem with that, but that video needs to be, I'm sorry, a little bit more professional, with zooming in the right places, in showing you like, oh, you remember the cards from 2 rounds ago? Then I used that one. okay, then show me this card again. Why, you expect me to remember everything that you talked about two rounds ago? That was 10 minutes of information of a completely new game. I have no idea what happened like 2 minutes ago. Then show me a reminder. Show me what's going on. Of course, it could have been wonderful if for every game, someone can come over to my place and like, hey, you want me to explain to you the game? No problem. Here how it goes. But it's not the reality. Now, again, I understand that maybe I'm the only one like this. Maybe people really use the rulebook just to like, as a reminder to like, what do I need to do in this case? But for me, the rulebook is like basically, what do I need to do to start this game going? And I don't expect to understand all the extreme cases. What happens if you have only 2 gold coins and your friend needs to go to the toilet and your boss is calling you? All right, I don't expect to understand which knight in this case I will be able to buy. All right, I get it. This is why you have glossary, but just let me get started with the game. Guys, what do you think about this? Did you ever have like a game that was extremely difficult for you to learn, to understand? What did you do in that case? And do you think that I should be more patient and like accepting? Let me know in the comments what do you think. Thank you for watching and see you next time.